Hello and welcome to the 2 minute series. The topic for today is currency convertibility. This is an important topic. Now, first and foremost, what we mean by currency convertibility is that it is the ease with which a country's currency can be converted into gold or, for that matter, another currency. It is extremely important for international commerce. Now, suppose I have 1 crore rupees in my account and I want to import something from the US with this money. So I will go to the RBI saying that please convert my 1 crore rupees into dollar, because I will have to make a payment in dollars. So the ease with which this money is what is going to be converted into dollars is what is currency convertibility. Now, first and foremost, vis-a-vis India, you should know that there are two accounts. One is the current account and the second is the capital account. Now, current account, as you all know, deals with short-term transactions, that is the import and export of goods, the import and export of services, as well as remittances. Now, in case of India, the current account is what is fully convertible, which means that any amount of transaction under the purpose of current account is what the government will fully allow for conversion. Whereas in the capital account, it is partially convertible. Now, why is this partially convertible? For instance, a foreign country wants to make an FDI in one particular sector, which allows for 51% of an FDI. So in this case, what is going to happen is that this particular limit is what the government will allow as fully convertible. Now, what happens is, suppose an Indian wants to invest in some foreign country, and if that investment is something that has a check upon it, beyond a certain limit in money, if to be invested in a foreign country by an Indian, is not what is allowed to be fully convertible. But this is for practical purposes fully convertible, because the tendency of Indians is that they are not investing beyond the limits that have been set by the government. So for practical purposes, even the capital account is what is convertible, but theoretically, yes, it is partially accountable. And often we read articles that the government should allow for full convertibility of capital account also. Another thing that you should know here is with regards to the reason why the government is maintaining these constraints. The government is maintaining these constraints because sometimes the government might not have adequate reserves to deal with such kind of convertibility. A sudden large amount of convertibility of rupee into dollar might impact the economy. It might lead to destabilizing of the rupee. So to ensure that the home currency is what is stabilized, the government keeps these constraints. So that's all for our discussion today. I thank you all for watching the video.